The death of a parent, a forbidden romance, a manipulative brother, rival families, and an arranged marriage. All this and more will lead to the tragic unraveling of poor Lucy Ashton, also known as Lucia de Lammermoor. Thank you for joining us on Opera Avengers. I'm Alejandra Martinez, your guide to demystifying opera, an art form created by the people, for the people, and of the people. Today's podcast is brought to you by FreshBooks.com. Move your small business's accounting to the cloud with a free 30-day trial on www.gofreshbooks.com/opera. Additional support is brought by Audible.com. Get a free audiobook download and 30-day free trial at www.audibletrial.com/opera. Choose from over 180 titles to read on your iPhone, Android, Kindle, or MP3 player. As always, this podcast will include spoilers. In opera, there are so many nuances to absorb that knowing the story beforehand allows you to sit back and enjoy the performance without worrying about missing a subtitle or two. So think of our podcast as your cheat sheet and be free to enjoy every minute of high-flying opera. Lucia di Lammermoor is a tragic opera in three acts, composed by Gaetano Donizetti. Written in 1835, it is loosely based on the historical novel The Bride of Lammermoor by Sir Walter Scott. Our story takes place in the mid-19th century in the hills of Scotland. On a sunny afternoon, a commotion erupts. An intruder has been spotted on the grounds of Lammermoor Castle, ancestral home of the Ashton family. The captain of the guard, Normanno, sends his men off in search of the intruder. Then, Enrico Ashton arrives, troubled. His family's fortune is in danger, and the only thing he can think of to save it is by wedding his sister, Lucia, to Lord Arturo. As an added bonus, the marriage would establish the Ashtons politically. The chaplain and Lucia's tutor, Raimundo, warns Enrico that Lucia is in a fragile state. She is still mourning the death of her mother, after all. Normanno tells Enrico that he suspects the intruder is Edgardo di Ravenswood, who has been carrying on a not-so-secret tryst with Lucia. Enrico is furious. He despises the Ravenswood family and vows to destroy the relationship. Meanwhile, Lucia sits by a fountain outside Lammermoor Castle with her maid, Alisa. Lucia is waiting, barely able to contain her excitement for her beloved Edgardo. Lucia comments that she has seen the apparition of a woman murdered at this fountain by a jealous suitor. Alisa warns her that this vision is a terrible omen, as a woman was indeed stabbed to death by a jealous man from the despised rival family, the Ravenswoods. Alisa begs Lucia to be wise and break up with Edgardo, but Lucia insists that Edgardo brings her great joy and that their love will conquer all obstacles, even omens and ghosts. Cue Edgardo. He finally arrives to tell Lucia that he must leave for France on a political mission. He will be away for a few months, but before he leaves, he wishes to make peace with her brother so that he can finally marry Lucia. Lucia protests, insisting that Enrico will never change his mind, and that it is better to keep their love secret. So, they exchange rings and vow to be true to each other before Edgardo must depart. He'll be away for a while, so let's take a quick break. Need to send invoices? Chart your expenses? Save it all to the cloud with FreshBooks. To try FreshBooks free for 30 days, just go to www.gofreshbooks.com/opera. Like reading, Audible.com is offering a free audiobook download in addition to a free 30-day trial to test out their library of 180,000 books, including The Book Thief by Marcus Zusak. To download your free audiobook, go to www.audibletrial.com/opera. Again, that's audibletrial.com/opera for your free audiobook. Act Two resumes several months later. In Lammermoor Castle, Enrico is overseeing preparations for the wedding of Lucia to Arturo. Enrico has already scheduled the ceremony for later in the day and even invited guests. But still, he worries if Lucia will go through with it. She has been resisting him at every turn. Normanno assures him that everything will be okay. He has intercepted all the letters Edgardo and Lucia have sent each other, and Normanno has cleverly forged a letter of his own. Lucia arrives, continuing to defy Enrico, but he shuts her down by showing her the forged letter, supposedly from Edgardo. It claims that Edgardo has forgotten her and taken a new lover. Lucia's heart breaks. Raimondo, the chaplain, arrives to persuade Lucia further. He reminds her that it is her duty, as Enrico's sister, to forget Edgardo and marry Arturo, to save the Ashton family and make her mother proud. The sacrifices she makes here on earth will be rewarded in heaven. Finally, Lucia agrees. Later in the castle halls, the family excitedly anticipates the wedding. Arturo arrives, but his bride-to-be is behaving strangely. Enrico tells everyone that it's because Lucia is still mourning her mother. Arturo promises Enrico that the marriage will return glory to the Ashton name, and then signs the marriage contract. Lucia, with some reluctance, signs as well. Suddenly, Edgardo throws open the doors and charges into the hall. He has arrived home earlier than expected, and he yells, "I claim my bride!" The hall descends into shock with the famous sextet, "Chi mi frena in tal momento?" Arturo and Enrico demand that Edgardo leave, but he reveals that he and Lucia are engaged. Raimondo steps in, cooling tempers and persuading the men to put away their weapons. He then shows Edgardo Lucia's signature on the contract. His fiancée is now married to another. Edgardo flies into a rage, cursing Lucia, tearing the ring off her finger and stomping it into the ground. Finally, Edgardo is dragged out of the hall and thrown out. Shocked and unable to bear the pain, Lucia collapses. In Act Three, Edgardo is troubled, reflecting on the recent betrayal at Wolf's Crag, his crumbling home by the Ravenswood family cemetery. Then, Enrico arrives to gloat, pouring salt into the wound. He teases Lucia is already enjoying her wedding night. Furious, Edgardo challenges him to a duel at dawn. Back at Lammermoor Castle, wedding festivities grind to a halt when Raimundo runs in front of the guests with a grim announcement. Lucia has gone mad and killed Arturo. Lucia enters the hallway drenched in blood. Her eyes are unmoored, her expression vacant, as she launches into Il dolce suono, the mad scene, switching between shocked emptiness to terror, to joy as she remembers her meetings with Edgardo, to tenderness as she imagines being with him on a wedding night that will never come. She realizes that she will never be happy in heaven without her Edgardo. Enrico returns, outraged at Lucia's behavior, until he realizes that something is seriously wrong with her. After their violent exchange, she falls to the ground. This time, she doesn't move. Meanwhile, at Wolf's Crag, Edgardo awaits his duel, lamenting a life without Lucia. He decides that a life like that is not worth living, and he plans to die on Enrico's sword. Then, he hears guests coming from Lammermoor Castle, gossiping. Lucia is dying, and she has called Edgardo's name. Edgardo prepares to run to her, but Raimondo announces that Lucia is dead. Overcome with grief, Edgardo kills himself with his own dagger. As he dies, he hopes to be reunited with Lucia in heaven. It's easy to underestimate the cultural endurance of Lucia di Lammermoor, but the songs, if not its name, have fully permeated pop culture. The sextet showed up as Jack Nicholson's ringtone in The Departed, and it was whistled by Tony Camonte before every murder in Scarface. Even the Three Stooges borrowed from Donizetti, lip-syncing the sextet to hilarious effect in their short Microphonies, and belting out a version with alternate lyrics in Squareheads of the Round Table. But the mad scene is probably best known for being featured in The Fifth Element, as hauntingly sung by the blue alien opera singer Diva Plava Laguna. Clearly, Lucia di Lammermoor will stand the test of time. Until next month, I'm Alejandra Martinez. Thank you for listening. Opera Avengers is a production of the Great Lakes Light Opera, an organization based out of Cleveland, Ohio, dedicated to bringing opera and all local musical arts to everyone. Want to learn more? Visit us at greatlakeslightopera.com. Want to help out? Check our donation page or email us at megan@greatlakeslightopera.com. Oh, and let us know what you'd like to hear next.